Hi students, Grace College of Engineering, Mobile Application Development Lab, 6th exercise, Android applications for multi-threading. So we will go to create the Android applications with usage of multi-threading. You know very well, threading means any job or any process. So multi-threading means at the same times it will do multi-jobs or multi-process. That is multi-threading. So we will go to develop Android application that implements the multi-threading. So the procedure is same as the above 6th exercise. This is the XML coding. XML coding is used for design the Android app. For designing purpose, we are writing the XML coding. So here we are creating one linear layout. Here image view. On that in linear layout, we will create one image view. For that image view, we are using the two buttons. When we click on the first button, it will load first image. When we click on the second button, it will load the another image. But if both button will use the same thread. Okay, same thread method. Okay, we will see the Java code for this program. This is the Java code, main activity Java code. So we are now first the package. We are importing the packages or classes for these applications. Next, image view. We are declaring the variable image in the image view format by a file. We are declaring two variables, button 1 and bt2 in the button variable. So to override every methods in the Java, in the Android app is override only. First we are writing the onCreate method. So while onCreate method is called, it is creating new activity, that is a new page, new Android page, okay, screen. So while onCreate, it will create a new page, Android phone page. So that activity main is the object. It is present in the layout object. In this layout object is present in the class or resources. Okay. So button, declaring all the variables button and button 2. We are getting the button to button. We are finding the button by using the method find view by id method. Okay. So this method is used to identify the button. Which is the button 1, which is the button is button 1 and which is the button is the button 2. Okay, by using the ID, we will go to identify whether it is a button 1 or button 2. Next, onClick listener method. We are defining the onClick listener. So we'll click on the button, it will listen. Which is the button we clicked? Okay, it is listening. Which button is clicked? Button 1 or button 2? Okay, we will click on click. On click, it is view. It is calling the object view. Okay, so it will call the object view. Maybe it is a first button, means it will load the first image. Okay, new thread. Here we are creating the new thread by using the variable new. New is the keyword, is used to create the new object thread. New runnable, we know very well, runnable is the interface, it is present inside the class thread. Okay, and it is overriding the method run, void run. See, note it here, void run method is there, and also here also void run method is there. Okay, two methods, it will do different jobs, but the method name is same. Okay, method name is run. Here also the method name is run. Here also the method name is run. But it will do different jobs. Okay. We'll click on the first button. It will load the first image. And it will call the run method. We'll click on the button 2. It will call the image 2. But it will call the method run. Okay. Both run method are same. Method names are same. So, next, we are setting the image. For the button click, we are setting the image by using the method set image resource method. Okay, this method getting the parameters r.drawable.india1. So, india1 is the image variable. It is passed to the drawable object. This drawable object is passed the India message, India image to the class R. Okay, this R is passed the India image to the variable image. So now image variable is assigned to the image India 1. So we are calling the activity through the dot start method. We are invoking the start process through this method dot start off. Okay, wa? Okay. So this is the second method, run method. Public void run. We are calling the method run. So when we are calling the method run, it will post the image variable. Okay. So how it is posting the image means it is calling the parameter runnable. By using the runnable interface, it is calling the runnable interface, and it get the image India 1, and it post. It is posting the India 1 image on the next window, next activity window. When we are calling the same void run method, okay, multi-threading. This run method is used to display the image India image. This method is used to display the image logo, any logo. Okay, so the output is, we'll see the output. It is running. For running purpose, we have to press the Shift plus F10 key. Otherwise, the green color triangle button. It is loading the image. When we click on the load image 1, it is loading the India image. When we click on the load image 2, it is loading the Grace College logo. The output is verified. Thank you.